What's up, ATG fam? We're gonna quickly take something that I thought would be impossible for me, particularly cold, which is contracting the glutes, taking the knees, quads through a full stretch. So as far as I can stretch and having the strength to lift back out of it. That's something I thought would be impossible, but that's the point that I was thinking about today is I put in sessions where the intention was not what can I achieve in that session, the intention was how is this session gonna make it easier to access my body later. So with a partially artificial kneecap in this knee, it would always tighten back up, but regress split squats, front foot elevated, regress, couch stretch, gently. Those two factors add up, then even the reverse Nordic itself, you can elevate your feet, because when you elevate your feet, you now actually have less of your own weight that has to lean back, and you can even hold a band. But that's kind of my point is now, I have like 10, 12 hours of driving today. I can pop off on the side of the road and get my flexibility workout like that because I have access because of the previous sessions I put in. So it becomes like an investment. So the better you get your investment, the easier it gets to make money. Now I get to live life completely differently because of all those sessions I put in with the intention of what is this session, this rep, this set doing to make it easier to access my body later. So now 30s are looking heck of fun. I'm trying to get even more explosive and athletic this coming year only by doing every single method with the intention of how am I gonna dunk when I'm 60? What is this doing for my tissues that's gonna add up for later? You see, I mean, so it's a totally different approach than you might think with how do I get explosive now? Actually, what changed my athleticism is that long-term approach. So hopefully this tip helps you in your session to give you an idea. That ATG split squat I mentioned, I did that on Monday in my program. Today's Wednesday, a flexibility day that includes the couch stretch. And then this reverse Nordic, which even though it regresses, I'm still keeping it just optional. 3 sets of 3 to 5 reps, 1 to 2 times a week can get phenomenal results if it's built upon the right things and not everyone has to do it. But for me, it gives me an incredible return on my investment for the time because I'm able to give my muscles something very powerful, which then adds up for the joints, giving them freedom, which is engaging a stretch into the muscles with load at the same time. So that shows to have extremely powerful effects in the body when you can stretch and strengthen an area. And my belief is that if you do it 100% pain-free, the results are even better than forcing through any pain. Hope it helps.